Josh Reese here with Glorious Takes. Got me a special guest today.
Hello, everyone.
Dolores Lozano, with a lot of different organizations.
Yeah, so right now I'm with ESPN Radio, and I just finished working for the Houston Super Bowl host committee, and kind of looking for my new job right now, so.
But she covers all the teams in Houston, yes, so if you're wondering why Dolores is here, it's because she has a lot of knowledge on not only the Houston Rockets, but the Astros. I even think she dabbles in some Texans every once in a while. So today we are here to talk about the MVP race, and it should be pretty much decided about now, right?
Yeah, I think
if your mind wasn't made up, it should be made up tonight.
I think so too. James Harden's having a remarkable season, and I don't think anyone can really compete.
No, it's you hear about the stats versus the wins. Tonight the Rockets beat the Oklahoma City Thunder by a score of 137 to 125. But when you look at the stats, Russell Westbrook put up 39 points, 13 assists, and 11 rebounds. So all those stat nerds out there are thinking, well, he's still going to average a triple-double for the season. He's going to win MVP, right? Mike D'Antoni, after the game, mentioned that, well, this could have been one of those games where James Harden scored 40 or 50 points. But
yeah, definitely.
Instead,
but he gave the ball to his teammates. Everyone was on fire today, so it was good to kind of see Lou Williams. Mm-hmm. He had a really good game. I think he had 31 points. Yeah, 31 points. So it's kind of good to see James Harden kind of giving his team more shots. So
yeah, it's just crazy when you look time and time again. James Harden is doing so much for his team. And I know people might think that we're biased because we're here in Houston and we see James Harden so often. But when you look at what the Rockets came into the season with, everyone wrote the Rockets off. They hired Mike D'Antoni. They signed Ryan Anderson. They signed Eric Gordon. Everyone thought the Rockets were jokes. Don't lie. Even you out there thought that the Rockets were going to be jokes too. But they have proved you wrong, and they've taken a team they've taken a team that was going to be an 8th seed maybe, and they've taken it all the way to the 3rd seed. What else is there for this Rockets team?
I think it's just Houston's year. We had the Super Bowl. The Rockets are just on fire. Eric Gordon, I don't think anyone thought he would win the three-point contest at the All-Star game.
That's right, Eric Gordon.
So
too, yeah.
Houston's just kind of blowing everyone away right now.
It's really mind-blowing to think. And, man, the last MVP the Houston Rockets had, of course, was the great Hakeem Olajuwon. And they went on to win the finals that year. It really seems like everything is coming together for the Rockets at the right time. And I know I just talked about it a second ago, but everyone had written off this team. But they have proved everyone wrong. All the doubters out there, all wrong. And I just don't know what else the Rockets can prove out there. They've won 50 games.
I really want to see them. The other day in the press conference, Mike was talking about winning 60 games. So I honestly really believe the Rockets could do it.
Well,
so we're at 51.
51.
Nine
after
more
tonight's
to go.
Game with the Oklahoma City Thunder, they got 51. They're going to be taking on They're going to be taking on the Golden State Warriors coming up twice. So that is going to be a major test for the Rockets. While the Warriors still don't have Kevin Durant back, it's still going to be a pretty big test. And I think it kind of might be a little bit even since Ryan Anderson is out too.
Yeah.
Kind of tip for tat. I know
yeah,
Ryan
I
Anderson.
Definitely agree. I definitely agree. I'm really looking forward to see Steph and Harden just go head-to-head and see who battles it out best that night.
Right. You
Tuesday
go
night.
From one MVP last year, and he's going to be
unanimous,
handing it off to
MVP,
the potential MVP this
yes.
year. So everything comes full circle. You go from Steph to Harden. So yeah, so many different takes from this game, so many different thoughts. I know going into the game, I kind of was worried that the Rockets were really going to struggle with Ryan Anderson out. But they proved that they could still hang and bang with a bigger team like Taj Gibson. They have Steven Adams, Enes Kanter. They can still hang with those guys, and they're not going to get defeated, even though they're much smaller.
Yeah, definitely. I think the Rockets are just proving themselves time after time. Eric Gordon had a really great game.
Mm-hmm.
Patrick Beverley didn't have any points, but he like did a lot.
Right.
He was doing a lot during the game. So I just think this team is going to go far, and hopefully we'll see them in the finals.
Yes, hopefully we'll see them in the finals.
We will see them in the finals.
Well,
speaking it into existence.
Speaking
it
into
it
existence
will happen,
is half the battle, right?
Yes.
So not really many other thoughts after the Rockets beat the Oklahoma City Thunder, but they're going to have a tough stretch ahead of them while Ryan Anderson out. While it did not affect them tonight, the Rockets are still going to have
almost
to find
the refs
their way.
The refs weren't quite on our side, or no. Houston's side tonight.
No.
But when are they?
Refs, I never really want to get into the ref thing so much because it always seems to even out at the end. Like, there's a lot of times when Harden gets fouled, and I don't want to blame the refs too much because if you do, maybe those fouls that Harden gets on the three-point line, maybe those might disappear.
Might.
So
as long as we don't get any fines for talking about them,
I don't think we get any fines.
Yeah, okay, cool.
Hopefully no one finds us. I hope not. So anyways, you can follow me on Twitter at Mr. Joshua. I would appreciate that. You can follow Dolores.
You can follow me at one Dolores Lozano. That's on Twitter.
Bam. All right, we are out.
Bye.
There you go.